are you excited to go through TransUnion to get it explained?
Yeah, it definitely is the highlight of my day.
Is this the first time you're reviewing your TransUnion?
Yep. I pay someone to look at my credit reports.
Well, he's got some outstanding invoices for you then. When you first look at your credit report, what's the first thing that you notice?
The score.
Yeah, so it is big, it is bold, colorful. That is what they want you to focus on. One thing that's really important is to look at the timestamp. So when you look here, you are seeing not today's date. Pulling your credit report for the first time, or you have or paying for it on a monthly basis, this should be today's date. Okay. If it's not, what you have to do is click refresh your score.
So how often do they refresh it?
So they don't refresh it automatically. Every time you go in, if you want the updated score, you have to click that button when it comes to TransUnion.
Oh, okay, so if you don't look at your credit report for a year, then it's just going to be
a year score. Old. Yeah, so that. So if you're wondering why your score's not changing, that might be one of the reasons, because it's just an old score. So look at that timestamp, and that way you can know that you're looking at a current credit report and the score is, I guess, updated on that. Okay. There's a lot of other things on the screen that can be overwhelming, but what I'm going to suggest is that you ignore the rest and go directly to the credit report tab. So we have the account summary here. First thing, once again, is the score. You have credit accounts underneath. When I say credit accounts, what do you think of?
Like credit cards?
Yeah. So credit cards, lines of credit, loans, mortgages, cell phone, that all shows up. And what this is doing, this section, is giving you a summary of how many you have showing up. When you're looking at the balance number, in a perfect world, this would be an exact amount of your total balance outstanding or debt that you would have. However, it's very common that when you pay off a loan or even some credit cards, that they keep the last balance outstanding and they don't update that. So that's what we call a hanging balance, us credit folks.
Wow.
All three of us, that's what we would call a hanging balance. And so if you're seeing that, that's something that needs to be corrected or disputed.
And so does the lender take care of that?
So you could technically, in a perfect world, once again, it should be done by the creditor or the lender, but they generally don't. Oh. So when you call them, they will probably tell you, oh, it's updated and corrected on our side. And that's all they can see, but they didn't update it with Equifax and TransUnion. So you'll probably have to do a dispute directly with the credit bureaus. And we have links on how to do that and what the next steps are in the show more, show notes, that kind of stuff. The next two are on the summary.
Payments.
Yeah. Self-explanatory. And
closed accounts.
Yeah. So this is just how many closed out of the total amount of the credit accounts that you have, how many of them are closed?
And what's a closed account? Just one you're not using anymore, or one that you've...
Yeah, so one that's inactive, or you've officially closed or paid off anything that essentially isn't valid anymore or helping the credit score.
So like a loan?
Okay. A loan that you've paid off, that's a good example. So then we have delinquent and derogatory. Does that sound nice?
Not really.
Yeah, they don't make it sound nice. But essentially, if you have any delinquent accounts, which is essentially any current credit accounts that have like missed payments, then that's kind of falls out under there. And any kind of public records like consumer proposal, bankruptcy, or anything like that,
okay,
it would show up, or collections, it would show up how many there are.
Okay.
Yeah. So it gives, once again, a summary of everything that's on your report, I don't pay too much attention to this just because some of the stuff isn't that accurate. You can review it if you want, but where my focus is going into the individual accounts. And so what you want to do is go up and it has the default summary tab, but when you go here and you click expanded view,
yeah,
it opens up all the different accounts.
Oh, okay.
So then we go into the personal information. Yeah. This doesn't affect your score at all, but it is something that you do want to confirm is correct.
So, oh, I've already found errors on there.
Who's your credit guy?
Oh my goodness. Should have caught that.
The name is important. That should be corrected. If your SIN number is incorrect, that should definitely be corrected. And your current address.
Okay.
Some of the other things, like your phone number, past addresses, maybe it has your parents' address on there because you live there, or maybe your employer's address as a previous. Not really a big deal, not worth correcting, but...
What if you have, like, errors on there? Are you supposed to call in to correct them, or do you...
Yeah. Then we go through all of the different ways you can dispute mm-hmm. these errors or get things corrected. More info. Mm-hmm. So. That leads to the next one, which is consumer statement. What's one of our nicknames for our son?
For Ben?
Yeah.
What?
2 cent Ben.
Oh, 2 cent Ben. Yes, that's true.
And why do we call him 2 cent Ben?
Oh my gosh, that kid always has something to say about everything. He may not even have an opinion on it, but yet.
It has nothing to do with him, but he weighs in.
He always has something to say.
So we love him, but he definitely is 2 cent Ben.
2 cent.
And this is what I call your 2 cents when it comes to credit. If there's something on your credit report that you do not agree with, you can dispute it, but maybe there's a backstory or you just want to give your 2 cents, then you can actually register a consumer statement on the credit report. And there's certain rules and scenarios where you won't want to do this. It doesn't affect your score at all, but it could actually keep you away from getting best rate financing. So you want to be careful when you use this. And I go through, or there's a link to go into more detail about when you shouldn't and some things to know. And then of course, how to do it.
Okay.
Then we have the inquiries. Hard inquiries are anytime a lender or creditor has checked your credit for the purposes of qualifying you for additional mortgage financing.
Is there any way to get those removed? Because there's a lot online.
Yeah, so you can dispute them, but there's a lot of scenarios where it may not be worth it, and it doesn't necessarily affect your score as much as one might think. We have a video that goes into that in more detail, the pros and cons of actually going and putting your effort in.
Okay.
So they stay on there for 6 years. If you want them off before, you can try and dispute them.
Okay.
So then we get into the banking information. I've never really seen anything show up on here unless it's an overdraft or something outstanding, or you've got bank account fees that they're coming after you for. They would show up under here or could be.
So overdraft shows up on your credit report?
Only if it's outstanding.
Oh, so if you're in the negative then.
Yeah, so, well, not even, like I meant, it's a good clarifying question. So when I say overdraft showing up on there, I mean, like, you have overdraft an amount and you just walked away from it.
Oh.
So, like, not every time you dip into there, it doesn't show up. There's some banks where overdraft will show up under the accounts, but most of them don't. So this banking section is only for, like, a year down the road, you haven't paid or something, or it's written off and they're coming after you. Then we get to the main meat and potatoes, if you want to call it that, but the main focus of what you should be checking as a consumer to know if it's correct.
The score.
Just kidding.
It goes against everything you said. It's okay.
So under the account tab, you're going to see different sections that they have. They have revolving, which is?
A credit card.
Or?
Line of credit.
You got it. So credit card, line of credit, then they have mortgages, loans, and then other for cell phone. We go through this in more detail on the Equifax one.
Okay.
when you're reading these.
Responsibility.
This is if you have a joint account, mm-hmm. it'll show up here. It well, may also say individual.
Oh, okay. Okay,
so we have other videos where we go into detail about, what do I call it? Do you remember? What, joint credit?
No. Should I remember?
Well, I have a video link.
Oh, gosh.
In the show more or
I
more
feel like you think I go home and like watch these videos and study them.
I know.
And
she does.
I do not.
She does. So with those, with that video, it goes into what I call joint credit roulette.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry. Yeah. The roulette.
Yes.
So yeah, really it's just the same word. You just add roulette to it.
It's completely different. Okay. Very important to check out, in there about some of the dangers or risks of joint credit. Going on. The other one I get a lot of questions about is high balance.
Okay.
Confusion about this. So this is the highest balance you've ever had on that account.
Oh, wow.
So on a credit card line of credit, it doesn't track how long ago it was, but just how the highest it's ever been.
And how long do these stay on your credit report
six
for?
6 years.
Oh.
At least 6 years, depending on the province.
Oh, okay. And yeah. That helps determine what your score is going to be.
Not that important, mm-hmm. Because that can change and lenders are more concerned about what your current balance is.
Yeah, I was going to say, if you really wanted to like find some dirt on somebody, you just have to like go through here and look at what their high balance was from like 6 years ago.
Yeah. So
like, oh, you're a risk.
Yeah.
That's not nice.
That's how you do it.
I don't know.
Hopefully they don't have access to your credit report.
Well, I guess.
But when it comes to...
It's like before you marry someone, it's like, I'm going to search your credit report and see what were your spending habits 6 years ago.
This is going to be on the next dating app.
Wow.
Or if I create a dating app, it's going to be all focused on credits.
Instead of like Tinder, you just do like...
Swipe left. Swipe left.
What's your credit report?
If you want to see your payment status, you have to click this tab. Which then goes in. And
the one that says payment status. Thanks.
This has your payment status color-coded for ease, but it also has a summary of all or how many times you've been 30, 60, or 90 days late.
Oh.
So when you're reviewing your TransUnion report, if you see old, good credit accounts on there, that's one thing that's unique about TransUnion as opposed to Equifax is they keep it on there forever. So old, good credit accounts, it's like a trip down credit memory lane. They keep it on there. It's only negative information that they automatically remove after 6 or 7 years, depending on the province once again.
Oh, okay.
If you've been through a consumer proposal, bankruptcy, lawsuit, or judgment, collection, OPD, anything like that, it shows up in the public record section. You would have to click the expand button in order to get the details of when it was closed or to confirm that it actually is showing closed. If you've paid it or settled it and it's showing outstanding, that is an error and that needs to be corrected.
So you would just send them, like, how do you prove that it's closed?
That's what we go through in the dispute video.
Okay.
So it goes into detail on how to do that, what documentation, what information
okay.
they're going to need. So we will save that conversation for another day.
Can't wait.
Looking forward to it. Yes.
So exciting.
If you have any other questions or want to learn more,
you can check out any of our social media and the links in the show notes or the more information down below. And we would be happy to go through it with you in more detail.